Well, today we wish a very happy 45th birthday to the internet. Well, in truth, pinning down an exact date for the birth of the internet isn't really possible, but some leading tech magazines suggest today is as good a day as any to celebrate because...
Well, it was on the 7th of April, way back in 1969, that the first RFC request for comment documents were published. And in fact, RFC documents describe the theoretical foundations of the internet and interconnected computers.
You know, all of that sounds very complicated, but you know, the truth is that the internet is, you know, for us, those of us living in this 21st century,
it's like the air that we breathe.
Right, something that we cannot go a day without. So we'd like to take a look at where the wired world is headed from here on out.
And of course, we're not going to be able to do it alone. To help us, we are joined live in the studio by Dr. Moon Song-chun, professor at the Graduate School of Management at the Korea Advanced Institute of Science and Technology.
Dr. Moon, it's great to have you back here. Welcome.
Hello.
Now, first off, let's first go over 4G. I think most of us have got 4G covered. Mm. We're either on 4G or LTE. Mm. And the word is that the internet is now advancing or heading towards 5G and a new technology called the IoT or the Internet of Things. Now, to be honest with you, I don't have a good grasp of what this is. So could you help us?
Yes. The one typical example of 4G is like this. The last October, the Joseon Ilbo was very successful in broadcasting 26-mile marathon race on live by his cell phone, LTE cell phone. But if you think of the Formula One race, which is much faster than marathon race, then 4G is not enough. We need more wider and higher data capacity. And that capacity is about 100 times more wider and higher. So that's the idea of 5G. In 5G, we have about the 10,000 lane road. And for comparison, 4G has only 10 lanes. That's the difference.
Huge difference.
Yeah, huge difference.
Astronomical. Well, let's try and name some names and have some faces to go with the technology that we have today. Which IT company would you say is the trendsetter or the trailblazer in terms of 5G technology today?
That's the Korean company like Samsung and Japanese company like Sony. And the Korea will host the Winter Olympic in 2018. Mm-hmm. And the Japan will host Summer Olympic in 2020. So Japan and Korea are very eager to show their position as a fast mover and trendsetter in 5G. So that's going to be the first ever 5G Olympic in the world. So they will make a history. And that's the idea. So the Samsung, Sony, NTT Docomo, LG, Electronics, that's it.
It's a Korea-Japan rivalry like no other,
right,
between technological giants rather than athletes there.
Not like in soccer.
Not like soccer. Well, what about the IoT or Internet of Things? Who's leading the way here?
That's definitely Google. The Google is the modern trendsetter. The Google acquired the Nest Lab, which controls room temperatures in living room. And the Google also acquired Oculus, which uses about this size of three-dimensional displays that can capture any object that can be seen. And once the object is captured, the detail of the object will appear in half a second from Google database.
Wow.
That's the idea of Google.
So this is the successful refurbished version of the Google Glass,
That's possible in reality now. Hmm. And that will be commercialized maybe in 5 hours' time.
Now, also marking an anniversary is something that we're more familiar with, the World Wide Web. Of course, last month it marked the 25th anniversary of the invention of the www dot. Now, what started as a way for scientists to share their research, in fact, it became or changed the worldwide life forever. Enlighten us a little bit on that as well.
Yeah. That was a very famous guy, a very the intelligent and great visionary called the Mr. Tim Berners-Lee. And he was a graduate of Oxford University, which studied the physics. And he later entered the master's degree program in MIT. Mm-hmm. And he stopped his study and moved to European the Nuclear Particle Research Laboratory, which later found out the Higgs particle.
Higgs boson?
Yeah, boson, yeah, right. And he was involved in a very big project in which 400 programmers code their program. And he decided the meeting and bringing 400 members in one to have a discussion, in one room to have a discussion is almost impossible and time consuming. So he decided to invent some concept like a homepage. By having homepage, the one programmer can visit another programmer's homepage and then have a look how the progress has gone and see what happened there and come out to their PC, his own PC. That's the idea of homepage.
Right.
So he invented homepage and made internet very simple to use and made it public with no reward in money.
Right. It
and
started
that
out
changed
with
the lives of all of us.
He's alive and
right.
57 years old.
Right.
Very gentleman. You know,
right. That's
English
a,
person.
Right. Very good deed on him. Uh-huh. So what more lies ahead in the world of World Wide Web and beyond?
The two keywords are digitization and connection. You know, the only 10% of the object in the world is connected. And only 10% of our work, which is done in analog, is digitized. For example, think about the black box in aircraft. It is still analog.
Mm-hmm.
It is not digitized. So, but the trend is that it will be digitized. It will be connected to internet server, and it will send the signal each second, so that the satellite can receive the signal and it can send it to the internet server, internet data center on the ground. So no, there is no need to have a black box in the aircraft or ship as of today. And we just need internet to be connected to ships or aircraft. That's what you can see in the future.
Well, a small invention that was created out of personal necessity has done something for the greater good, the rest of the world.
That's right.
Right. Yeah. Well, Dr. Moon Song-chun, we could go on and on, but unfortunately, we ran out of time. We look forward to having you back here soon. Thank you for coming.
Thanks, indeed.